Hello and welcome to Prudent Media News, the top stories this hour. Kunkoli land controversy takes a different turn. John Fernandez demolishes road constructed for Football Academy, claims his ownership on the land. BJP, NCP, both candidates claim lead in Penne Taluka. Ponda police arrest Mahanand Naik under rape and murder charges, accused confesses of murdering two women in 15 years. Little Champs rock Burns on Saturday. And children enjoy football festival enthusiastically in Santa Cruz. Now the news in detail. The land which was acquired for Football Academy in Pazar Khani in Kunkoli is in the news again. The road constructed on the land has been demolished by John Fernandez. He claims to be the owner of the land. With this act of Fernandez, the land controversy has taken a different turn.
On Sunday, road constructed for Football Academy in Kunkoli was demolished by John Fernandez. 1,26,000 square meter of land was acquired by government. Now Fernandez claims that the land belongs to him. This John Fernandez is the same person who had contested against Miki Pacheco in last assembly election and had lost by just 750 votes. Taking all this into consideration, it seems like this land controversy has landed into a political fight, where Alemau and Pacheco are at loggerheads again.
Property survey number 146/19 is what I bought. And what the government has acquired is property number 146/1, 15 and 16, where nowhere I am concerned with it. And illegally they have acquired my land, or not acquired, they have taken possession of my land, made a road in my property, which I am free to demolish. I think after paying a certain amount of money, I can enjoy my property. Where I don't know who has encroached my property, who has made a road, I don't know, which I am demolishing.
Goa Housing Board had acquired this land for housing projects, but people from area opposed to it. Later, Urban Development Minister Jokhi Alemau decided to construct Football Academy. But Housing Minister Miki Pacheco delayed the transferring of land and plans of Football Academy was dropped. Kunkoli Chairperson Felon Vaz has filed complaint about this incident to Kunkoli Police Station.
आणि त्यानं मग सांगले आमगे गव्हर्नमेंट प्रॉपर्टी डॅमेज केलं झालं वसन कंप्लेंट कर म्हणून, पण त्यानं सांगले चीफ ऑफिसरा कर म्हणून. चीफ ऑफिसरा फोन मला, चीफ ऑफिसर मी लग्न गेला असा बेतालपाणी, मागे म्हणाल चीफ ऑफिसर म्हणून लागलो एम ई सांग म्हणून आम्ही उदयाक, उदय आणि कोणा काणकोण लग्न आहात, फायनली आय टू कम एंड लॉज कंप्लेंट.
कुंकोळी पी आय संदेश चोडणकर गेव अस मोर डिटेल्स.
कंप्लेंट ड्युबी असा फिलॉन वाज म्युन्सिपाल्टी चेअरपर्सन आणि आणि एकलो दुसरो आपण रॉने डाय असं म्हणले. त्यांच्या कंप्लेनी प्रमाणे आम्ही ते म्हणतात गव्हर्नमेंट प्रॉपर्टी कोण तरी ते डॅमेज करता म्हणून आम्ही गेले व्हेरीफाय केले जाल्यार थंय जो मनीस काम करतालो तेजे कडेन ऑर्डर बी आहा कलेक्टराची ते लँड हें करपाक कितें करपाक क्लीन करपाक आनी तेणें जे डॉक्युमेंट सबमीट केल्या प्रायमा फेसी अशें दिसता की ती जागा ज्या जाग्यान तो काम करता ती जागा तेजी तरी आसतना फाल्यां हावजींग बोर्डाक आमी कॉन्टेक्ट करून जागा कोणाची आनी हें कितें तें व्हेरीफाय करून फर्दर एक्शन घेतले.
आर रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम कुंकोळी रमेश नायक राऊत.
2 days after the election, BJP North Goa candidate Shripad Naik claims to have dented Desh Prabhu's home ground Perne, claiming a lead of 10,000 votes, whereas NCP Congress North Goa candidate Jitendra Desh Prabhu is confident of getting substantial lead in Perne and Sattari Taluka.
Speaking to Prudent Media, North Goa BJP candidate Shripad Naik claimed at least 35,000 minimum margin in North Goa. However, he also claimed 10,000 margin in Perne Taluka itself, which is home ground of Desh Prabhu.
Minimum एक level ले उसे कले होने, जैसे कि हमको मैट ले maximum छोड़न दिया, परंतु minimum जो हम जी votes पटे हैं, हम जी जो percentage यानी lead असली, ती lead साधारण हम जी एक 35,000 आसपास आसा, ये minimum धुरन. ताजे वेर हमें दूसरों तो हम तो मुद्दा, हमें जब तुमको फाटी मंडी लें कि आम्ही हे मार्जिन आमचे 58,000 जे आसा ते मार्जिन आम्ही क्रॉस करतले मॅक्झिमम जाल्यार ते आम्ही निश्चितपणे क्रॉस करू शकता. साधारण पेडणे तालुक्याकूच जवळजवळ आम्ही मांद्रे पेडणे आणि धारगळ आणि पेडणे म्हणून एकच जाला आता, पण पेडणे आणि मांद्रे म्हणून जवळजवळ आम्ही 10,000 जणांची लीड आमकां मेळटली.
Naik also admitted that this time Vishwajit factor in Sattari Taluka will deprive BJP from getting lead in Sattari, but he is also confident that will not make much difference in his victory in North Goa.
तुम्ही 37 दर विषय केलो 70 ने वाळ पाय ई जवळजवळ आम्ही माझी विश्वजित राणे केदेव आरोग्य ठोकूनी 18 दराची किंवा 18 दराची लीड आम्ही घेतलंय किंवा 16 दराची लीड घेतलंय त्याची स्टेटमेंट असतात वेगवेगळे परंतु आमची जी लीड जी असा साधारण आमकां त्या हातून ज्या लीड जरी ना मिळी तर 9 हजाराच्या वयर ते केन्नाच वचचे ना आणि हे जवळजवळ डिचोली मय हे जे असत त्या लीड आम्ही थंच त्यांची कंपेन्सेशन जी तांकां लीड मिळली ती थंच आम्ही कंपेन्सेशन करू शकतो.
NCP Congress candidate Jitendra Deshprabhu is confident in getting substantial votes in Pedne and Sattari Taluka. He said these two talukas will play important role in winning North Goa seat for him.
I have left it to providence as to how much may have come in the kitty, but I'm sure it was twice as much as that with the saffron party. I will say that in Pariye, the Congress NCP combined out of 16,995 votes which are polled, the Congress should get Congress NCP combined should get above 11,000 votes.
And in Valpoi?
Similarly, in Valpoi, it should exceed 11,000 votes.
Deshprabhu also claimed 30,000 minimum margin in North Goa.
The Congress NCP combined will get anything between 145 to 149,000 votes. That is what I roughly estimate. And this rough estimate is at the lower end of it.
And the lead you expect is between 1,000 to 49,000?
No. Anything above 30,000 would be an estimated lead, by virtue of which the Congress NCP alliance can return the seat here in the North Goa.
However, Sattari's strongman and health minister Vishwajit Rane is also claiming maximum lead in Sattari for NCP Congress candidate Deshprabhu.
Valpoi, we will give a lead around 6,000 because for the first time Uzgaon has become a part of us. So approximately 6,000 from Valpoi and 10 to 11,000 will be the lead in Pune.
Our principal correspondent Murari Shete with video journalist Ganesh Hotkar for Prudent Media.
Ponda police arrested Mahanand Naik of Shiroda. In a shocking confession, the accused admitted murdering two women, one from Shiroda in 1994 and another from Ponda in 2009, both with one aim of stealing gold ornaments. The accused has been arrested on charges of rape, robbery, murder and causing disappearance of evidence.
Ponda police acted on the complaint lodged by the deceased brother of missing report of her sister. After thorough investigation by the police officials, Mahanand was arrested. The accused also confessed that he had raped and killed Yokita Naik in order to acquire her gold ornaments. He also admitted of killing Darshana Tukaram Naik with a motive of robbing her gold ornaments and murdered her in 1994. The accused is now under police custody. Our reporter in Ponda, Vivek Prabhu.
In our next segment, Jitendra Deshprabhu alleges BJP of violating code of conduct. Artemisia Mascarenhas celebrates her 100th birthday. Let's take a short break.